3 SSBN are confirmed ready with one more under the active mode of fitment. We'll see get the fourth within 16-20 months in water. Arient Arient is more than 4 VLS cells, while Aritamin is more than 8 VLS cells as well. Third one with new 125 megawatts reactor with longer life and improved design. Noise level further improved due to improved material and design maturity. INSARIANT began sea trials in December 16, 2014 in Bob with 9 months of sea trials and afterwards another 9 months of weapon testing. INSARIANT fired K-15 prototype in full operational configuration from a depth of 25 meters in November 2015 after conducting multiple dummy tests in September to October 2015. INSARIANT did ejection test for K-4 and K-1 in February 2016 with 4 tubes ejection in a matter of seconds. The dummy included a mix of K-4, K-1 and K-15, 3 different mission load configs from the same tube, replicas for a full discharge of its onboard ballistic firepower. INSARIANT fired K-4 in a highly depressed trajectory in full operational configuration from a depth of 30 meters in March 2016 for approx 750 kilometers. This was followed by INSARIANT firing a full capacity K-4 MK-1 at a range of tilde 4,000 kilometers in ANN region. This was covered up by multiple BrahMos test in ANN in simultaneous days and Navria warnings issued for the same to clear out the hull area in the pathway. INSARIANT started deterrent patrolling from July 2016 onwards. 4+ months long operational deployment of ARIANT done multiple times in busy slots too. Second SSBN first launch in April 2016 and even participated in a naval exercise. Limited capacity owing to deployment of ARIANT in a deterrent patrol mission, in the later part of 2016. Couple of tests of K-15 from submarine launch and one test of a depressed trajectory K-4 done as well. These tests are not ejection tests, it's a full-fledged operational test of the SLBMs. K-5 ejection test completed, next set of tests will be done as per schedule. Payload very different than before and capable of hitting multiple targets at a distance of 200 plus kilometers from the original target as done by unitary warhead. Codenamed K-6 with MIRV is in final stages along with land version A-6. A range of 8,000 to 10,000 kilometers is expected, based on twin configurations. It's expected to be green-lighted for testing this fiscal. SSN reactor will come out soon. That reactor will also be used for heaviest SSBNs, 16 silos housing only ICBM of longest range. Indian Navy also had focused on miniaturization of nuclear reactors for different classes of ships usage both surface and underwater. The approach seems to be with a mindset of a new policy where Navy in future wishes to have super carriers, mini carriers, 10-12-ton missile and SAM complex laden battle cruisers types etc. It's of course studying perhaps for a new plan of naval expansion in shipbuilding. BARC though wishes to not go towards miniaturization. BARC has successfully come out with research supportings for dual core and expected to come out in future multi-core design. This basically implies BARC can up the speed quicker for any new naval requirement in terms of tonnage for surface and underwater fleet much quicker than anticipated from before. Some of the supporting entities wishes to keep it exclusively to Russian consulting, but DRDO has categorically said French consulting is expected as part of agreement. Interesting time ahead for Navy if things go as per plans. We might see new classes of long endurance ship with heavy stuff coming out of drawing boards within next decade and yards getting ready for building such capital ships.